Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in today's video, we are going to see how the Hartley oscillator using op-amp is implemented, what is the frequency of oscillation, and how the circuit of Hartley oscillator looks like. So let's begin with the topic. Hartley oscillator is considered as one of the LC oscillator. In case of LC oscillator, a tank circuit or a parallel combination of capacitor and inductor is used as a feedback circuit. So, when we use op-amp in inverting configuration, the op-amp introduces a phase shift of 180 degree between input and output signal. The circuit to be work as an oscillator, the amplifier circuit required to provide a phase shift of 180 degree, and according to Barkhausen's criteria, the total phase shift is required to be 0 or 360 degree or integral multiple of 360 degree. So to satisfy this criteria, we require one more circuit that can introduce a phase shift of additional 180 degree so that the total phase shift around the loop becomes 0, 360 or integral multiple of 360 degree. Therefore, we require a circuit that can introduce a phase shift. In Hartley oscillator, the feedback amplifier or the feedback circuit introduces a phase shift of 180 degree, and op-amp in inverting configuration uses a phase shift of 180 degree. So let's see the circuit diagram of Hartley oscillator using op-amp. So from the circuit diagram, we will come to know that op-amp is used in inverting configuration, which provides a phase shift of 180 degree. The output is given back to the input through a feedback network. The feedback network introduces additional phase shift of 180 degree. So the total phase shift around the loop becomes 0 degree. This satisfied the first conditions of Barkhausen's criteria. Now, if we look at the feedback network, then it consists of a parallel combination of inductor and capacitor. Therefore, the Hartley oscillator is considered as one of the type of LC oscillator and basically used to provide the high frequency signals at the output. The high frequency signals comes under a video range, and therefore they are also called as video frequency oscillators. Now here, the coil L1 and L2 are wound on the same core. Therefore, we need to consider the mutual inductance between them. Here, the value of L equivalent is given by L equivalent equals to L1 plus L2 plus 2M, where M is a mutual inductance. Now, the frequency of oscillation is now depend upon the values of inductor and capacitor. So, while considering the value of inductor, we always need to consider the value of mutual inductance if it is required to consider. So, the frequency of oscillation is given by F equals to 1 upon 2 pi square root of L equivalent into C. Now, when we consider a feedback network, we need to consider the feedback factor. So, in this case, the feedback factor is given by beta is equals to XL1 upon XL1 minus XL3. We know that to have a total phase shift of 0 degree or 180 degree, the value of XL1 minus XL3 is equals to XL2. Therefore, when we substitute the value, we will get value of beta as beta is equals to XL1 divided by XL2. We know that the value of reactance of inductance is given by a formula 2 pi FL. So XL1 is equals to 2 pi FL1 and XL2 is equals to 2 pi FL2. So when we substitute this value, then we will get beta as beta is equals to L1 by L2. To have a sustained oscillation, or according to the second Barkhausen's criteria, the gain of op-amp is required to be greater than equals to 1. That means mod of A beta is required to be greater than equals to 1. We have the value of beta as L1 by L2. Therefore, the gain of amplifier is given by, therefore, mod of A is equals to L2 by L1. So when we consider the mutual inductance between the coil, then the same formula can be written in the form mod of A is equals to L2 plus M divided by L1 plus M. So this is how we can calculate the gain of inverting amplifier in case of Hartley oscillator. Now let's understand what are the advantages and disadvantages provided by the circuit. The LC oscillator provides advantages like it is very easy to tune, it provides wide range of frequency as it is used for providing the high frequency application, therefore it is used in the TV and radio receivers. The disadvantages of the circuit is that the poor frequency stability. And that is because of the effect of temperature, effect of humidity, effect of change in the parameters of the component value of inductor and capacitor. Because in case of LC oscillator, the frequency is dependent upon the value of inductor and capacitor. And it is given by the formula F equals to 1 upon 2 pi square root of L equivalent into C. So if the value of component is get changed due to any of the effect, then that will affect the value of frequency. And because of that, the frequency stability provided by the circuit is get decreases. Now there are various applications of Hartley oscillator using op-amp. And the applications are, it is used as a local oscillator in TV receivers or radio receivers. It is used in the function generator for providing various waveforms of any desired frequency, and it can be used in the RF source. So basically, the generalized applications of oscillator includes as a waveform generator, as a local oscillator for providing the frequency having a different values of different magnitude. So this is what about the Hartley oscillator using op-amp, in which a combination of inductor and capacitor is used as a feedback network, which introduces a phase shift of 180 degree, and inverting amplifier of op-amp introduces a phase shift of 180 degree. So I hope you understand the topic of Hartley oscillator using op-amp. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ikira. Subscribe Ikira. Thank you.